Alright, Shalom. So, Brother Daniela, coming back again with another lesson. Giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Racha, HaKodash. Double honor to the elders and apostles, a great millstone. And Shalom to the hopeful elect brothers and sisters that believe in this word and that fear in the Heavenly Father and His Son. And I'm going to title this video, and I may do multiple parts or two parts. Vehicles of salvation and destruction. And what do I mean by vehicles of salvation and destruction? I'm referring to the chariots. And in the time that we're in, the chariots are going to be destroying, beaming down fire upon people and crushing them and turning them into powder, right? But also saving the elect, you know? And this is why Habakkuk, in the third chapter, he prays to the Most High to have mercy, you know, in his wrath. So this is Habakkuk chapter 3 and verse 2. It says, O Lord, I have heard thy speech and was afraid. O Lord, revive thy works in the midst of the years, and in the midst of the years, make known in wrath, remember mercy. So we want the Lord to remember mercy, for us, you know, who are teaching and preaching. We want the Lord to have mercy upon us once he brings his wrath down, you know, upon the wicked, you know, the wicked of our people and, you know, this nation. It says, the Most High came from Teman and the Holy One from Mount Paran, Selah. His glory covered the heavens and the earth was full of his praise, right? So that glory covering the heavens is what? That's the presence of the chariots and the innumerable multitude of the angels, right? Because when certain prophets describe the chariots, they describe them as being bright, you know, or having a certain type of brightness to them, you know? That could be synonymous with the word glory. Right, and that's explained in 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, when it talks about the celestial bodies, the sun, the moon, and star, right, where they all differ in glory, so one shines brighter than the other, right? And here it is, verse 4. It says, and his brightness was as the light. He had horns coming out of his hands. Now, when you go into the word horns here in the Hebrew, it goes into a beams of light. In other words, a laser beam, right? And also it uses the word horns, which we know represent what? Power. Okay? So it says, and there was the hiding of his power. So those beams of light, that concentrated fire is the power that the Lord is going to utilize or use to, as the scriptures say, beat people into powder, right? So the chariots are going to come and be destroying things, and the Lord is going to cause things to be finished with the the nuclear missiles. All right. It says, and there was the hiding of his power. Before him went the pestilence, and burning coals went forth at his feet. Right. He stood and measured the earth. He beheld and drove asunder the nations, and the everlasting mountains were scattered, and the perpetual hills were bowed. His ways are everlasting. So the Lord is going to bring great pain and affliction through his chariots. What, you know, people call today UFOs, flying saucers, or UAPs, unidentified flying phenomenons. I saw the tents of Kushan in affliction, and the curtains of the land of Midian did tremble. Was the Lord displeased against the rivers? Was thine anger against the rivers? Was thy wrath against the sea, that thou didst ride upon thy horses? Right, horses represent power, and thy chariots of salvation. So it's talking about anger, right, or indignation and wrath. Because the Lord is going to destroy these different rivers, these different rivers over here is also going to be, you know, evaporated and burnt up. This whole place is going to be a desert, right? But it talks about angers, and then it talks about what? Wrath, chariots of salvation. So the Lord is going to be angry with the wicked, but he's going to be bringing salvation unto the elect. So that's a vehicle of salvation and destruction. And of destruction. So let's get the word for vehicle real quick. Like I said, this may be a two-part video. I'm only on the first precept. And I got a, you know, like 6 or 7 other precepts that to go to. So I like to break things down to the last compound. As do other brothers, right? And that's what the elders have done also in the different sit-downs, the iconic sit-downs. They break things down to the very last compound. As Elder Apostle Ramlob would say. Let's get vehicle. This is a medium through which a drug or medicine is administered. It says any means of conveying or transmitting, right? Means of from vehiculum, means of transport, vehicle, carriage, conveyance, right? And the word vihere means to bear or to carry or convey. Right, to move, to transport, right? They will transport the elect into safety, out of way of the destruction, but also you know, that's a vehicle, you know, but also they will administer, right, transport that fire down from the chariots to destroy people. So let me see here. We're going to get one more precept, and I'm going to come back and do it again. You know, it was a quick lunch break on the Shaddai. So now let's get, I'm going to go to the Book of Psalms, chapter 68 and 20, because we know the Lord has the power to save, but he also has the power to destroy. So this is Psalms chapter 68 and verse 20. Verse 20. It says, he that is our power is the power of salvation, and unto the Most High the Lord belong the issues from death, right? So he is the power of salvation. And just as Habakkuk prayed, he wants the Lord to have mercy upon us, all right? So that we may have salvation, right? Mercy upon the elect, really, right? Because the issues of death come from the Lord, all right? So he kills and he makes alive, as it says in 1 Samuel, the 2nd chapter, right? He wounds and he heals. He maketh rich and he maketh poor, right? So on our behalf, we want the Lord to have mercy upon us, all right? So this, you know, a quick one. I'm going to do another part to it, you know, a continuation of it. The Lord will, you'll be edified. Shalom.